In many games, jumping is an essential mechanic to progress through a level or to stomp on enemies. In this series, we'll set up some basic platforming gameplay logic in Stingray to upgrade Servo's moveset to jumping. Go to File, Project Manager. Create a new project using the empty template. Rename it Servo Jumping and store it in a local folder. Stingray restarts and compiles your new project along with the included assets. Open your project folder from the asset browser. Copy the content and script folders from the files provided with this movie into your local folder. When this is done, go to Edit, Level Testing, Refresh to recompile your project with the newly copied assets. Open the level Servo Jumping. Then, click the green play button to test your level. You can move Servo using your game controller's left thumbstick and control the camera using the right thumbstick. We assigned a mover volume to Servo to detect collisions with nearby obstacles. To display this mover in the test engine, first go back to the Stingray editor and select Test Engine from the status bar's drop-down menu. Then, enter physics debug underscore movers on in the command line. Stingray displays Servo's mover in the test engine as a wireframe capsule. Notice that Servo can't move downhill or fall to lower levels. This is because we are only controlling Servo's X and Y coordinates while the vertical Z axis remains constant. To fix this, we'll add gravity to Servo's movement flow graph. Right-click Servo and select Open in Unit Editor. Go to the Unit Flow tab. This flow graph builds on the work we did in the Controlling Game Character Basic Movement tutorial series. We converted the previous flow structure into modular flow subroutine nodes, which are similar to functions in programming terms. On each frame, the Input Controls node evaluates the player's input controls and outputs a direction vector, input magnitude, and usage flag. The Rotate Character node uses these values to calculate Servo's rotation in relation to the game camera. The Character Speed node sets Servo's movement speed, which can either be custom or based on the skeleton's root motion. Finally, the Move Character node combines the resulting rotation and speed values to translate Servo's mover. Open the corresponding flow from the asset browser. In this flow graph, we first extract a direction vector from Servo's rotation. Then, we multiply this vector by move speed to obtain Servo's delta position vector. However, this vector's z value remains at zero since we're only controlling the x and y axes. Create a vector components node to split the vector into its xyz components. Then, add a vector from components node to recombine the x and y components only. Duplicate the following get numeric variable node and rename it vertical speed. Connect it to the z port on the vector from components node. Next, we'll create a gravity flow graph using the following equation. Set the gravity strength to the desired value. We encourage you to experiment with different values since gravity is relative to your project's world scale. Group the gravity flow graph as apply gravity to vertical speed. Connect the flow graph to the sequence node to update vertical speed on each frame. Also, connect the nodes from the debug group to your flow graph to display the results at runtime. Save your changes and test the level. Servo can now move downhill due to the force exerted on its mover's z-axis. However, notice how vertical speed decreases on each frame. This creates a problem when Servo runs off the platform, which results in a teleportation more than an actual fall. To fix this, we need to trigger our gravity flow graph only when Servo's falling and lock vertical speed to a minimal value when grounded. This requires that we check for collisions or a lack of collisions between Servo's mover and the surface beneath. Create a Get Mover Collisions node. Then, connect its unit port to a Get Unit Variable node and its down port to a branch node. Group the three nodes as Detect Ground Collisions. Note that for more intricate collision detection, you can also use a dedicated Raycast node. While Servo's mover uses overlapping volumes to resolve collisions based on its capsule shape, the Raycast node can be used to accurately predict the intersecting point between a line and a mesh. This leads to more accurate detection, but can also be more resource intensive. We want to use the gravity flow graph when Servo is in the air, so connect it to the branch node's false port. Then, duplicate the following Set Numeric Variable node and connect it to the true port. Set its value to negative 0.1 to create a minimal downward force. Lastly, insert a max node between the addition and Set Numeric Variable nodes to limit Servo's falling speed. Save your changes and test your level. Servo now falls from one platform to the next at a realistic pace. In the next movie, we'll update our flow graph to implement jumping.